And welcome to the Warrior Report here on HBC TV 25. I'm Justin Barrientos. Thank you for joining us. We're brought to you by Russell and Associates and coming to you from the 111 Riverfront Building, Palatch Development Center in downtown Winona. And here is always Brian Bergstrom to talk about Warrior football. And I guess we say congratulations and I'm sorry for both of those things, because you still have a share of the NSIC South title. But unfortunately, you lost to Minnesota Mankato. And your reward for that, you still get a playoff berth, but now you have to go up to Bemidji to play. So there's a lot of parts moving in that. What are your feelings on that so far?
It's been an interesting weekend. We obviously were disappointed in the game result on Saturday, but a breath of new life yesterday with the NCAA playoff selection show, and had a pretty good idea that we thought we were still in, but there's nothing like hearing your name, and we would go anywhere, play anybody, anytime. So we're just ecstatic to keep playing, and Bemidji is our next opponent, and really happy for our guys to be able to have a week 12.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll talk a little bit about that in our last segment here, but we want to wrap up the game first against Minnesota State Mankato, and from what I understand, it's kind of cold, which is what you'll face this coming Saturday. And they kind of jumped out to a big lead. What happened in that first half?
I think we got beat. You know, I don't have it wasn't like this one area where if we would have fixed this in this small part and you know, we got beat. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that happens. Yeah. And they're a good football team. They're one of the most talented teams that we played. And we certainly didn't play our best. And when that happens and you're on the road and in that stage of a game, you know, Mankato's played a lot of games like that where conference championship on the line, late in the year, cold weather game. They were at home, we're obviously on the road. And I think you need to go through some of those games and fail to learn how to win those games. And, you know, we certainly weren't good enough on Saturday to do that. And they give them credit. They deserve to win the football game, and they did. And but I don't think it didn't come down to one area. Sometimes in sport you get beat and your effort wasn't good enough compared to theirs. Can we beat them? You bet we can. We certainly didn't play like it on Saturday though.
There's obviously a couple of cliches that always kind of go through my head when we talk about a game like this, and the first is, well, we weren't ready to play, which I don't think is right. It's obviously, even talking to the guys last week, everybody was really ready to play against Minnesota State Mankato and get that home game possibly in the playoffs. And then the other thing, as you kind of said too, is that this might be a good thing to kind of get hit in the mouth so that you're ready for the competition that comes up, but you're going to be playing an NSIC opponent you're maybe familiar with. Do those cliches kind of work for what happened this week?
Yes and no. You know, I think I do think we were ready. It wasn't, we don't look back and say, man, that was an awful week of preparation, or the travel that day didn't work. We were ready to play the game. Now, once the game starts, you have to play at a certain level that's probably a little bit higher urgency than a regular, it felt more like a playoff game, you got to bring that next level that it takes, and we didn't do that. But maybe that's a blessing for this week, because it's going to be another big stage, another cold game, you know, going back up to Bemidji where we lost a game, but completely different weather this time. So I think that the Bemidji game earlier this year, and the Northern game this year, and the Mankato game this year, those are three losses being an 8-3 team. Those arguably have taught us more about ourselves and things we need to get better at and grow than the 8 wins. And that's how you got to look at it. And certainly we would love to be 11-0 and playing at home and all that stuff, or have a bye, but it's not the case. But we did learn a lot in those. And I can guarantee this. I can't guarantee the score, but I can guarantee we'll be a better football team this Saturday than we were last Saturday.
Well, in the second half of the Mankato game, you were a better football team, and you were able to get some points on the board and move the ball a little bit more. What changed between the first half and the second?
I think it was more of just a mentality. We really challenged them at halftime that this isn't us. We know we're much better than this. We got to have much greater urgency. and how do you want to be remembered? Like, what kind of legacy do we want this team to have? One that finished and finished strong. Even take away the win and the loss. I'm not even talking about that. Like, how do you want to be remembered as a finisher? And to stick together in adversity. I mean, that's one thing I remember saying in the locker room is, you know, we're going to battle arm in arm here. You know, we're gonna go win together. We're gonna lose together. We're not gonna splinter. And they did that. We came out and we forced a takeaway, and we went and scored a couple touchdowns and built some life back in, and it wasn't enough.
What were some of the things that you saw in that second half that you can build on for this week?
Mm-hmm. We just played. We weren't hesitant. We weren't waiting one half step to make sure something happened. We were more of the dictator. We would dictate our own actions as opposed to reacting to everything. And I think we got more used to the environment a little bit. And like I said, over the years, Mankato's has probably played in more games like that in terms of the stage that it was on. And we got to keep working for that, and we're going to use it as motivation. And we'll get there someday. Mm-hmm. I don't know when, but that's the path we're on.
It was not a great day for the running game, obviously. And you know, that's kind of the cold weather thing. You got to have that running game going. What did you see in the Mankato defense that you'll be able to use this week to plan and to be better in the running game this week?
Well, Bemidji and Mankato are similar in terms of some of their strengths, and they're both very good up front and very long. And Mankato was, I feel like, the strongest team that we've played, up front especially. And I think we have learned as coaches what kind of we found some runs that were working better, and that'll help us narrow in on what we like against Bemidji this week. Mm-hmm. And I think our guys understand now the level that we may have executed at the same rate the week before at Upper Iowa, and it was good enough, mm-hmm. because of who we were playing versus this same behavior, the same intensity level, the same urgency isn't good enough because of the team we're playing at Mankato or Bemidji. And it's just another reminder, we can't base anything off of who we're playing with. It's just got to be our best. And if it's our best, then we're in control of the standard. We're not saying, well, it was good enough because we were playing this team, or not good enough. We just got to be our best all the time and then let the chips fall where they may.
All right. One more kind of question about what happened against Mankato, and that's the defense. And there was almost 500 yards of offense given up by the Warrior defense this week. Where did you see, you know, some of the things that can be fixed from that game?
Big plays and fundamentals. So we very rarely let them just execute all the way down the field, 3 yards, 4 yards, 5, 10, 1, -2. Like, it was, we had a bust that created a big play, 20 yards, 30 yards, 50 yards. And it's inexcusable. We got to be better. I got to be better. It all comes back to me. The root of some of those, though, were a poor tackle or poor vision. So I was looking at the wrong thing. So I was in the wrong gap. Looking at the quarterback when I should have been looking at the man. Things that we can fix, but we're going to have to fix. Mm-hmm. Because anybody you're playing now is going to be very, very good. That's the nature of playoffs. So we consider it a blessing to get exposed to that, but then still get to keep playing, you know? And that's credit to the NCAA selection committee for looking at the body of work. It wasn't just one game they were critiquing us on. It was the last 11 weeks.
Yeah. Well, I want to thank you for coming in and talking about that. I know that it's difficult to talk about a loss like that, but I thank you for answering the questions and coming in. And it's not a sad occasion because you're still a co-NSAC South champion. Right. So that's a good thing, too. And then, of course, we have the game to look forward to this week.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, thank you for that. And we'll talk a little bit later in the show about Bemidji coming up. We're going to take a break here on the Warrior Report. And when we come back, we'll talk with some of the players. Kaiwan Vendrowski will be first right after this.
For over 60 years, Russell & Associates has been helping individual and business clients achieve what matters to them. Our trusted advisors have the expertise and experience to help with long-term plans for personal finance, business finance, or wealth management. Focus on what matters most. Call Russell & Associates Certified Public Accountants and Advisors today at 507-452-3100 or visit us online at russellcpafirm.com.
And welcome back to the Warrior Report here on HBC TV 25. We are brought to you by Russell & Associates and coming to you from the Latch Development Center at 111 Riverfront Street in downtown Winona. We're going to talk a little defense now with Kaiwan Dombrowski. Thanks for joining us here today.
Thanks for having me.
And let's talk a little bit about your high school career. You know, you're a football player and a wrestler. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about that and how both sports kind of helped each other out.
Well, I wrestled for 8 years coming into high school, and I kind of quit for a little bit. And then senior year, I came back to it after football season. And it actually, I feel like it gave me the upper hand coming into college with like how hard workouts were, the difference in competition and stuff like that. And just being able to fight through and gaining mental toughness. So I feel like that wrestling background gave me a real edge coming in.
And how did you decide then that football was going to be the sport that you wanted to play in college, and how did you get here to Winona State?
Well, I don't know, I've always had a love for football since I was a kid. You know, that's always been my dream, to be a college football player, so it wasn't really too hard of a decision at all for me.
Okay. Let's talk a little bit about the switch then from high school to college, because here you are, you're a big senior in high school, a big player, and then you have to sit your first year in college. What was that like, and did the wrestling and the mental toughness help with having to sit that 1 year?
Well, it's a big change going from the top kid of your school to coming to a new school and having to fight your way all the way back up to the top again. You know, and the level of competition is way different, way different. The speed of the game is way different as well. It's like,
What was that first game like this season, on defense and kind of getting your first taste of college football?
I don't know. It was a lot different than I used to feel in high school. Because I feel like they prepare us a lot better in college than we used to in high school. So in high school, I used to get super nervous and stuff like that. But for some reason, I don't know if it's because Coach Berkey prepared us or I prepared myself or what, but I just felt super confident coming into my first game.
Okay. We watched you on the defensive line this year, and we've just seen you excel in your first year. What's it been like to have the success that you've had in your first year of college football?
It feels amazing to know that all the work you put in, because we had COVID year, and then I had a redshirt year, so I had 2 years without playing football. Mm-hmm. So it just feels amazing to know that all the work I put in has paid off and shown in my game.
And what's it like among your other defensive linemen, gelling as a team and as a unit?
It feels great. We got a great brotherhood on the defense. I feel like that's why we connect so well and we're able to play as one unit, whereas we're not having like one guy have a great game and the rest of us have bad games. We're all firing on all cylinders.
Okay. And then you faced a little adversity this week against Minnesota State Mankato. The defense has been so good, especially on run defense, and then this week you kind of had a little misstep. What was that like to go through a game like that?
It was a punch in the mouth from the jump. You know, we got exposed on everything we did wrong, and we realized we have to fix those coming into Bemidji, or the same thing's going to happen. So we just have to lock in this week, go 1-0 in every meeting, every practice, every lift, everything. And hopefully the result is different. Mm-hmm.
What are some things that you're going to do in practice this week specifically to kind of build off of what happened last week to go into your first playoff game?
The main thing for me is mental reps. You know, we got to lock in even when we're not in, take the mental reps, and like picture yourself out there on the field in those situations.
Okay, and last question here. You know, what's it going to be like to go out and play in a playoff game? I know it doesn't happen all the time at Winona State. This is the first time in a couple of years that you've had a playoff game. What do you think it's going to be like for you to be out there?
I feel like the energy is going to be different, especially with, you know, the guys on the team that haven't been to playoffs before. I feel like we're just we're ready to play, especially with it being Bemidji, who we lost to in the beginning of the season.
Yeah.
We're going to come out with a chip on our shoulder for sure.
All right, very good. Well, thank you for joining us here today, and good luck against Bemidji this week.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to take a break here on the Warrior Report, and when we come back, we'll talk with Mason Carnell right after this.
For over 60 years, Russell & Associates has been helping individual and business clients achieve what matters to them. Our trusted advisors have the expertise and experience to help with long-term plans for personal finance, business finance, or wealth management. Focus on what matters most. Call Russell & Associates Certified Public Accountants and Advisors today at 507-452-3100 or visit us online at russellcpafirm.com.
And welcome back to the Warrior Report here on HBC TV 25. We're coming to you from the 111 Riverfront Building in downtown Winona, the Latch Development Center, and we're brought to you by Russell & Associates. And time now to talk to Mason Carnell. Thanks for joining us here today. Redshirt freshman, kind of the same thing that we talked about with Kaiwan. You know, what's it like to go from high school where you were an all-conference team captain, and then you have to sit for a couple of years as a redshirt? What was that like for you?
Yeah, I mean, it's tough coming in and not being the top dog again like you were in high school, but it's cool to see the people before you and kind of learn for a couple of years, and then when it's your time to go, you're ready to go.
All right. Offensive line, specifically center for you. It's a job that's important on the football team, but there's not a lot of glory in it. We talked to Coach Olson earlier in the season, and a lot of times you hear a lot of the negative. What is that like for you to play a position that you know is key, but sometimes you always hear all the bad stuff about it?
Yeah, I mean, I take pride in it. I think from a young age, I started playing O-line right away, and I just knew that was my calling, and making holes is what I think is fun. I think just watching the running back in the end zone, that's all I need. It's a thankless job, but that's all I need is to score as long as we win.
All right. Walk us through like a play, like a general play, because I think a lot of us football fans that watch that maybe didn't play the game, they don't really know everything that goes into it, because obviously you have to make a good snap to the quarterback, and then you got to get ready to block.
Yeah.
So what's that like for you?
So I just try to get the ball back as quick as I can. I try to get my hand free, because you got a hand in between your legs as soon as you snap it, so you're already at a disadvantage, and I'm a little bit smaller, so... getting that back is my first thing, but just kind of reading how they line up, how much weight they're putting on their hand, if they're back, seeing if they're going to play games. There's a lot that goes into it, but...
How difficult is it to make changes on the line right before a play starts? Because I know sometimes we'll see like the defense switches up and maybe you're not quite ready for it, and then all of a sudden you have to make a change. What's that like?
It's nice playing with the guys that I play with, especially having older guys, because they help me out with things. If they see something, they'll say, hey, out here, and we can make a flip call or we can switch things up right away, and the quarterbacks give us enough time to switch things up, so that's nice.
Okay. I know that you talked a little bit about blocking for the run. There's a good stable of running backs in the backfield for Winona State. What's it like to block for those guys?
Yeah, it's great. It's easy to block for those guys. Sam, he runs hard. He's a bigger guy, and I love when he gets in the game. He always finds the end zone, and then Ty is very shifty, so it's like really different. Dom's the same way, and it's awesome. So.
All right. We talked a little bit about the Mankato game this week and how it was a little bit more of a difficult game than what you faced earlier in the season. What was that like for you on the offensive line to face the adversity that you did this week?
I think it's just staying together. It wasn't the way we wanted to start coming out. And, sometimes you just got to tip your hat and say we didn't come out the way we wanted to. And I think that's just going to put a chip on our shoulder for next week. And we're blessed to have another week of football, so...
Yeah, and it's another week against an opponent that you're kind of familiar with.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that and what this game against Mankato is going to do to kind of propel you guys to play better against Bemidji.
Yeah, I think it just fires things up. We know we can compete with that team, and that's going to be our main focus this week, is coming out hot and staying up. But definitely puts a little fire under the seat with how things went last week.
Last question, is there anything that you specifically have to work on in practice this week to get ready for the playoffs?
Yeah, I mean, just the same things that I've been working on all year. Great snaps and firing off the ball, making sure my assignments are taken care of so we can find the end zone a couple times on Saturday.
All right, very good. Thank you for joining us here today. Congratulations on what you've done so far, and good luck against Bemidji.
Thank you for having me.
All right, we're going to take a break here on the Warrior Report, and when we come back, we'll talk with head coach Brian Bergstrom about this playoff game on Saturday against Bemidji State. That's coming up right after this.
For over 60 years, Russell & Associates has been helping individual and business clients achieve what matters to them. Our trusted advisors have the expertise and experience to help with long-term plans for personal finance, business finance, or wealth management. Focus on what matters most. Call Russell & Associates Certified Public Accountants and Advisors today at 507-452-3100 or visit us online at russellcpafirm.com.
I'm a pretty calm, cool, and collective guy, but... Sorry, what's your name? Yeah, Evan. Hi, Evan. Yeah, we have no internet. Nothing. I don't know. It just stopped working.
The internet is down.
I know. I'm on the phone with them. No, that was my wife.
I can't get online again.
Yeah, I'm just telling. I'm talking to Evan.
He's
no, my daughter, my wife. Okay, can you guys not talk? Sorry. Yes, we have white. Yes, the white boxes. I see one. They got horns on them.
It's the one with
they
the horns.
Horn. Like, yes, I see one. We have 11 of those.
I was on the phone and I got disconnected.
Okay, it's not about you. We switched our broadband service provider. Like, Devin put in 11, Evan. How are we supposed to know which one's 7 and which one?
I thought
one?
It was Devin.
Who's Devin?
I got no service.
Honey, you're blocking.
You can't stand there. You're blocking it. Don't block it.
And the best part, I never have to speak to Evan or Devin ever again.
I think this one's 11.
11? We're not looking for 11. No, we're looking for... Are we looking for 7, Evan, or 11? We have two next to each other. That's bad. Two white boxes. Evan? Evan?
And welcome back to the Warrior Report here on HBC TV 25. We're brought to you by Russell and Associates and coming to you from the 111 Riverfront Building, the Latch Development Center in downtown Winona. And we're joined now by Coach Brian Bergstrom again to kind of talk about the playoffs coming up, which is pretty exciting. Talk us through, you know, we talked a little bit in the first segment, but there was a watch party that was held to watch, you know, the selection show and that. And what was the reaction to finding out that you did get that playoff berth and you would be having at least another week of football?
Yeah, the room was loud, and excitement and a relief and a joy. And our team was there, our staff was there, a bunch of families of our coaches and players were there. Some of our administrators were there and members of the FPA and just fans and some professors. So it was a mix of our football family. And it was just a really good feeling to know. We had a pretty good idea that we had our chances were high, but it's also a vulnerable time where if it didn't go well, you know, I had my talk prepared if it didn't go well. And it was not just the team in there, it was outside people too, but people that cared about us enough to be there. So it was a really fun day, and it helps you move on from the Mankato game, certainly. Yeah. Because we got another one to go. So,
yeah, we talked before, even before you took this job here at Winona State, you were no stranger to the NSIC, but four teams from the NSIC make the playoffs. How do you rank this conference? Is this one of the toughest conferences in Division II?
I think so. I'm obviously biased, and I know how good this league is. And in terms of Division II, I just have... You know, I have my experience with the old North Central Conference when I was at St. Cloud State, and then the NSIC when I was at Augustana, and now here. And I do know that it's great competition week in, week out. I do know the conference is more balanced now than it used to be, meaning the bottom part of the conference is better, I think. And we do well when we play against other teams in the playoffs. We don't get a chance to do it a ton because we have all conference games. There is no non-conference. So this is the only opportunity we get is playoffs, and now we're all playing each other still. So, yes, it's really good. And there's other good leagues, too. It's just a real cool brand of football, Division II.
For you specifically, first year as a head coach, we talked about that earlier in the season, to lead your team to a playoff game, what's that like for you?
A ton of gratitude and just really excited for our players and our staff and to be a part of the journey with them. And it's not easy to go through transition at any time, but especially when somebody like Coach Sawyer is retiring, which is, he's such a figure, still is, in Winona, at Winona State, in football, and 25 years, and it's not easy. So just really thankful that our team bought in, and they bought in when they didn't know what the result was going to be. They believed when they didn't have guarantees, and that's faith. And challenged them in January, buy in now, and you figure out why later. Well, we've been finding out all year, you know, conference championship and playoffs, and well, this is why you bought in then. If you would have waited till now, it's not going to work. So you just got to, it's just a great lesson, like the power of belief, the power of faith. You're not always going to have proof of everything before you have to go 100% into something. And if it's worth doing at all, it's worth doing 100%.
Mm-hmm. How do you approach this week, and how do you feel the team approaches this week? Because, I mean, even this week's game could have been, okay, if we lose, then maybe the season is done and the same thing again. I know that you want to go positive and everything, but what does this week look like in practice and preparing for a game and everything from your standpoint? Mm-hmm.
Well, we're gonna handle it as if we knew we were playing a week 12 in terms of our schedule. Like, we're not going to dramatically change how we practice or when we practice or how we travel. We want to stay as normal as we can that way. I think what needs to elevate is our urgency, just knowing that, okay, now this is it. If we don't win, we are done. Where it in the season, you got the next week and you got the next goal, and well, this is it. So it's our urgency to define who we are. Who is this team? You know, here we stand at the, we're 0-0 in the playoffs. We're trying to go 1-1-0, but you know, we're not 8-3 anymore. We're 0-0. Mm-hmm. And the cool thing about the playoffs is everyone is. So everyone has got an equal shot.
Again, a question about preparation for this week. Do you prepare against a Bemidji team that you've already faced, or do you kind of clear the slate a little bit and maybe even ignore that it's Bemidji? Do you just prepare for an opponent this week?
It's a combination. We certainly are using how we defended them and how they attacked us last time. We're also studying how have people attacked us since then. Mm-hmm. Are there trends? Every week people are doing this to us. And then we're also studying what has Bemidji been doing since we've played them. So it's kind of three-pronged. And I wouldn't say there's a specific formula, like it's got to be this, you look this much at this segment, and you take it all in, and then that's the objective part. And then the subjective part of being a coach is figuring out, okay, how do we put this all together in something that's digestible for them? Because they got to go out and play on Saturday. They're not robots, you know, calculating tendencies. That's the coach's job, to get this information, get them the most important information, and so they can go out and play the game. They're the ones that make plays and win the game. Mm-hmm. You know, coaches, hopefully by Saturday, are able to pull themselves back and let them go do what they've been trained to do.
All right. Health-wise, how are you going into the playoff game?
Good. We, you know, everybody that was playing in Mankato is going to be continuing to play this week. So we had some guys that are dinged up. Shoot, it's a long season. So, but nothing that we can't battle through at this point.
All right, and then you've been doing your luncheons to kind of drum up support for Warrior Football, which was started a couple years ago. You're going to continue that for this playoff game?
You bet. As long as we keep winning, we're going to keep having them Thursdays. We started about 11:40, 11:45 at the Riverport, and we get done about 1 o'clock. All the coaches are going to be there this week. So it's been a great year every Thursday. So love to see everybody there.
All right. Well, thank you again for everything that you've done so far this season. We'll be cheering you on, watching the game against Bemidji this week. And good luck this week
at
Bemidji.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. And thank you for joining us here on the Warrior Report. And we will see you next time here on HBC TV 25.